I don't wear makeup, I don't own makeup, and I never will. And that is part of my identity. This is Sarah from Your Ideal Self, and if this is your first time here ever, then welcome. I make videos about growth, personal development, and inhabiting your best self. In this video, I'm going to tell you the top 5 reasons that I do not wear makeup. Now, the first 3 reasons are identity-based, meaning that these reasons are ones that I identify with to my core, and those things are the reason I don't wear makeup. And the last 2 things are more external-based. So I understand it's not all me. There are other reasons I don't wear makeup. The only makeup that I do wear is either lipstick or lip gloss, and for the purposes of this video, I'm not wearing any. Disclaimer, I am not saying that people should not wear makeup. People can wear makeup, they cannot wear makeup, I don't care. This is how I grapple with makeup, and however you do it is fine with me. Bonus, make it to the end of the video, and you can see me wearing full-on makeup. One, I strive to be content in my body without changing a thing. I don't want to wake up, look in the mirror, and not like what I see. I don't want to have to feel like I have to change my face to get on a Zoom call or to go to a meeting. I don't want to have to look at my face and think, I really can't go into the rest of my day if my lips don't look bigger, or my skin doesn't look smoother, or my eyes don't look bigger. When I feel fit, I feel comfortable. Exhibit A. Exhibit B. Exhibit C. Exhibit D. 2, I want to save time in the right places. Makeup, as we know, can take a while to apply. And I love the idea of being able to wake up, get ready real quick, and be ready to go. But this point is an interesting one, and it's the reason I put it as part of my identity. Because I spend a lot of time caring for my body. Probably more than people spend putting on makeup every morning. How do I take care of my body? I exercise, I eat well, I cleanse my face, I moisturize, I care about my body a lot. Looking good takes time, whether it's through just plain taking care of your body or putting on makeup or a combination of both. Now for a quick word from our sponsors. My cats own me. And we're back. P.S. If you like the cat paws, then I suggest you subscribe to the channel and click that notification bell because I almost always have cat pauses in my video. 3, cost. Or the female tax. I've only heard the term female tax in something I read, but the way I interpreted it is that the female tax is what we women have to pay just to be women. Like makeup, for instance. How expensive is makeup? Very expensive when you think of how much you have to use it, how much you have to buy, all the complexities in makeup. It's a lot. So there's that tax to be a woman. Then, of course, accessories, purses, jewelry. These are things women are kind of expected to wear, expected to have, and that is another cost in itself. I don't like to think that I spend more money than the opposite sex just so I can look the way I'm supposed to, or look just any certain way, or have certain things that are expected of us females. Now we have made it to the last 2 reasons, ones that are outside of Sarah's control. 4, my mom doesn't wear makeup. What can I say? Mama doesn't wear makeup. Little daughter looking up to the mama doesn't wear makeup. That's just how it is. When there's a wonderful woman you look up to who doesn't wear makeup, who is amazing, you just might not ever wear makeup like that person. And five, I got lucky. I happen to have some fairly good features that others might say are desirable in a human face. Smallish nose, biggish lips, long eyelashes. What can I say? I got a little lucky. But I could not take care of myself, my health, my body, and I could look much different than I do. So let's not forget the strength that we play in the health and beauty of our bodies. Who wears makeup or doesn't wear makeup? Let me know in the comments below. I want us all to be happy and confident in our skin and our mind. And if we have a set of core values that we always follow, we can do just that. I encourage you to check out my video, Create Your Personal Core Values with Me. I'll link it here. This has been Sarah with Your Ideal Self, and I hope your day is as meaningful as you want it to be.